Hello, my name is Ryan Gerber. I'm here today at Hunter Engineering to showcase the integration between Hunter's Ultimate ADAS and Hunter's ADAS Link. Today we're going to show a procedure highlighting this 2024 RAV4. Let's go ahead and get started. So, the first thing that I'm going to need to do is capture the VIN on the vehicle to begin the procedure. I simply use my barcode scanner, capture the VIN. Now I need to answer a couple questions. Let's go back up to the console. So the first choice you see up here is Hunter's Ultimate ADAS with ADAS Link. That's what I'm going to be using today. However, if you are using a factory scan tool, a J-Box, or a remote diagnostic service to trigger the calibration, you could choose Hunter's Ultimate ADAS with the on-site scan tool and still complete the procedure. All of these are possible with Ultimate ADAS. But one huge benefit of Ultimate ADAS is ADAS Link. ADAS Link will provide the most integrated, seamless experience. So I'm gonna go ahead and use either my handheld remote or the keyboard to go ahead and choose Hunter's Ultimate ADAS with ADAS Link. My next question would be whether I'd like to continue with or without an alignment. In preparation for this video, I did meet all manufacturer specifications for preconditions to do ADAS calibrations, as well as plugged in my ADAS Link's VCI. So I'm going to continue without an alignment. I'll add a couple of qualifiers. This is not a TRD or an adventure. Now I need to choose which calibrations I would like to highlight. For today's video, I'm going to simply do a sequential recognition here on the front-facing camera. So that's the only one I'm going to choose. So as you see, that integration begins. I'm going to start a pre-scan with ADAS Link. Following the on-screen prompts, I will go ahead and go to my requested procedure list on ADAS Link. Notice we already have our vehicle pulled up. And we'll begin our pre-scan. So I've started my pre-scan of the vehicle. I'm ready to continue. Now what I need to do is make sure that I'm able to see all of my targets. Simply lower down the boom on my Ultimate ADAS to bring all targets into view. Now that I can see all targets, I already have my vehicle in neutral. I'll simply move my front wheel chock, short roll forward, re-chock the wheels, my pre-scan's complete, so I'll go ahead and go back to my requested procedures list. You'll notice now I have my sequential camera recognition populated. I'm gonna go ahead and start my calibration. First thing it says is to use the scan tool. Again, I'll go back here and I'll do that front-facing sequential recognition that I chose earlier in the procedure. Now we'll be into some of our prerequisites that I outlined earlier that we had completed. And now we're at the first step of Ultimate ADAS and ADAS Link integration. So let's go ahead and begin that. We've already met our home position. We're gonna double check that we have enough clear space in front of the vehicle to complete the calibration. Ultimate ADAS does this using green laser lines and red laser dots. As you can see, there's a pictograph on the screen showing how we can look at that box in front of the car for the space that we need. As you can see, we have clearly enough space in front of this vehicle to complete the procedure. Next, what we want to do is make sure that there's nothing in the way where we're going to move Ultimate ADAS tower to continue. Our red dot lasers are indicating the tower placement on the floor. There's nothing in the way, no drains, no oil drains, no toolboxes. We're in great shape. But what we do need to do is we need to measure where that floor is so that we compare it to where the vehicle is in case we're on a surface mounted rack or there is a floor height variation. We'll go ahead and complete that procedure now. So while Ultimate ADAS goes ahead and does that measurement, next thing we'll be able to do is move that tower back. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna line the red lasers into some white pillboxes on the base. Let's go ahead and do that. Once I've completed that, we'll continue on. At this point, we're going to need to add a target board. I'll grab one of the target boards and mount it directly to the rail on Ultimate ADAS. Now that I have Ultimate ADAS tower positioned and a target board on, the next thing I need to do is add a target to the rail. So as you see, it's asking me to add target number 34. So for easy identification, target number 34 is clearly labeled with a diagram of what the target looks like as well. So we'll take target number 34 and add it to the target board. We'll go ahead and progress. We'll let Ultimate ADAS Tower go ahead and adjust to the proper height. Now we'll make some lateral adjustments. As you can see, you get a nice bar graph that makes it very easy for you to line up the target. Moving the target in to bring the bar graph to green for my first position. I'll move out of the way and let Ultimate ADAS go through a target orientation procedure. Once target orientation is complete, we'll automatically progress to using the scan tool. So I look down at the scan tool and it tells me I need to go ahead and continue once I have the target placed to calibrate for our first placement. Now that I've completed that first placement calibration, I'll move to my next step. You can see that I must move now the target to the left. Just move that target right over, keeping an eye on that bar graph until you get the green check marks. During the orientation step, Ultimate ADAS will leverage its 4 degrees of roll, pitch, and yaw to make a perfect target placement for the vehicle. Back to the scan tool for my second placement. Go ahead and begin that calibration procedure. Once that second step in the calibration procedure is complete, I'm going to continue to the third and final placement. Bring that bar graph right into green. Once that target orientation is complete, we can now go back to our scan tool and complete the calibration. Now that I've completed all three placements and all three calibrations, I'm going to complete a post scan for documentation. Once that's complete, I'll go ahead and finish up here on Ultimate ADAS, and we'll send all that documentation to HunterNet2 so that you can have that documentation to share with your customers. Thanks for watching.